All right, so everything looks good. We're gonna go straight into it and let's get into it. So, like the live stream says, resetting the password on AD. Everyone's done it. You know, you load up your AD, you locate your user, and I have a user called Bruce Wayne. I can right click on it and I can reset the password. Everyone has done this. That's cool, but I'm a fancy dude and I love using PowerShell. So I'm going to show you guys how to do that PowerShell. Now you are able to right click on the start menu, go to Windows PowerShell here and do all the commands within the AD. But I do not like to do anything within the domain controller. I like to do everything remotely. And that's typically with a workstation, with my workstation, and I just run the PowerShell commands to the AD and make the changes. So from here, we're going to run Windows PowerShell ISE. I already have it, you know, pinned to my taskbar. But if you click on your start, and let's type in Windows PowerShell ISE. I'm gonna run this. This is what I like running because it gives you the command prompt as well as a nice blank page so you can type in then run it. I'm gonna run it as an administrator. And I'm gonna hit yes for the user account control, and we're gonna run it. First command is import module active directory, and you have a couple options with PowerShell. You can highlight it, and then you can run it. But if you have the cursor at the end, if you click F8 or you click this button here, it actually runs this selection. If you have like a bunch of commands, you can run this, which runs the entire script, if it is a script, or F5. I typically do F8 or I just hit this button. Once you hit that button, let me zoom out real quick because you're not gonna see what's gonna happen. Zoom out. It's gonna import. If this is your first time importing the modules, you should see like a progress bar and it's gonna start doing its thing, or and it's gonna start installing and whatever, and it's gonna disappear and it should give you this command prompt, which is good. That means it's imported. Now, if you wanna know if everything was imported correctly, the next command that we're going to run, let me zoom in for you guys real quick. The next command that we're going to run is git command. And you can start typing. And I think I have, if I go into edit, I'm gonna click on Smart IntelliSense. It should give me, as soon as I type in, it should give me like a nice little tooltip. Or you can hit the tab and it should autofill for you. I love that feature. Autofill, it's awesome. So I am going to do a parameter of module, and the module is going to be the Active Directory module that we imported, right? And I'm going to run this. Now, if you go bottom all the way to the bottom right here, you're going to see all the commandlets that were imported or you're able to use within PowerShell dealing with Active Directory. There is a crap load of it. There's a lot of them. There is a lot. We're not going to go over all these because it's just too much to go over. Player a variable, and the variable I like to, it depends on how you want it. I'm going to declare a variable called pass. Now pass is going to be assigned to the following. It's going to be convert to secure string. I think if I do auto tab, convert, oops, spell convert wrong, convert to. And then if I do tab, there it goes. Convert to dash secure string. Now, open and close quotations. And then we're going to finish the command first. And then we're going to do as plain text, which is one of the parameters. And then we're going to force it. I'm going to hit tab on that, force it. Now, in between the open and close quotations is going to be the password that you want. So let's give it 20. BTNHD 2024. So the next command that we want to run would be the following. Now we're going to be using the Active Directory commandlets. So the first one that we want to do is set AD account. And the one that we want would be password. So hit tab to autocomplete. The parameter that we want to be will be identity. We're going to do, I think you could do open and close quotations or no open and close quotations. I'm not going to use it, but I am going to identify the user account. So it would be the user's UPN, user principal name. So it would be Bruce dot Wayne. All right. So we just identify the user account that we want to set the password. So the next parameter that we want to do would be new password. And now the new password would be what? It would be the variable that we just declare the password, which would be pass. And then what we want to do, run another parameter of reset, because that's the whole purpose of this command, right? Set AD account password to Bruce Wayne. The new password is actually set to pass, which would be 20, BTNHD 24, and then reset. Now we gotta finish it up. So we're gonna do another command of set AD user, right? And the user, we're going to do a parameter of ID. And the ID would be what? The AD user. So that would be Bruce. And the parameter would be change password at login. And make sure it is set to true. Boom. So this is the command. All right. Let's run these commands. We're going to run the first one, which is this guy right here. I'm going to put the cursor at the very end. And I'm just going to run it. We're going to run this command here. We're going to run it. Again, I got the cursor on line 8. For the hell of it, let's just select it and just run it. Doesn't really matter. And then bam. And let's go other user, Bruce Wayne. And let's use our new password, 20 exclamation point BTNHD 24 exclamation point. And let's hit the little I because this is the password, right? That's the password. So let me zoom in for you guys real quick. That is the password that we set, right? 20 exclamation point BTNHD 24 exclamation point. And I'm not lying. I wrote it down. Seriously, I wrote it down. So let's, we can hit the little arrow to submit, or you could just hit enter. I'm going to hit enter. There it goes. It prompts us. The user password must be changed before signing in. Let's click OK here. Ah, nice. All right. And we can hit enter to submit. It is changing the password. Hopefully that fits the GPO policy. It did. The password has been changed. Let's press OK. And Bruce Wayne is logging into his account. And I'm out. I'm about to stretch out, work out, and do a quick run. And hopefully you guys stay healthy, drink a lot of water, stay safe, and I catch you guys on the next live stream. Peace out.